it's Brittany, and I know I look like a mess. I just woke up, but today I want to take you along the journey of all the steps I take to get ready for a big event. It's kind of a lot of stuff, but if you want to be like super glam, then this is your video. So let's go. Step one of getting ready for your big event is going to be a face mask, at least for me. And I'm going to use two different ones. I'm going to use the Bourjois, bright white face mask on the highlights of my face, and then the Origins Clear Improvement on the rest of my face. So I'm gonna start with the bright whitening mask. Again, we're gonna put this on the highlights, anywhere you would normally highlight. So I'm gonna take that here. It doesn't need to be perfect, ooh, but don't get on your eyebrow like I did, because this one will peel off. And it should look something like this. Ooh. And I'm gonna take the other mask and pretty much put it everywhere else. Now you should look something like this or whatever kind of face mask you use. While you let it set, I'm going to whiten my teeth. I'm using the Mr. Blanc. And this is something you can do over time. It takes 14 days, 2 weeks for the full effect of the whitening to work, but you will see results in a couple of days. I see results even in a day because I have such stained teeth from coffee. I drink a lot of coffee, and so this is kind of a necessity to me. This is what they look like. This one is the lower, and this one's the upper. I'm gonna start with the lower first. Once I put this on, I won't be able to talk. Well, I mean, I will, but I don't like to talk with these on. They are really easy to use. They're just like the simple, flexible ones, not like the hard to use trays. I'm not a big fan of the trays. And I'm just gonna blot my teeth to make sure they stick perfectly. I start with the lower one. And here we go. Yay! And let shit for 30 minutes. And voila! White teeth. I'm just gonna brush away any excess. And the teeth are done. If you have sensitive teeth, I really suggest this one because I have really sensitive teeth and this one doesn't hurt me at all. The worst is when like you whiten your teeth and then you go like, you breathe in and it freezes your teeth and you're like, ah! And my face mask is done. The white peels away. At least that's what it says. I noticed this one doesn't peel as well as the black version of this. I'm not sure why, so I'm gonna peel off as much as I can, and then I'm gonna hop in the bath to move on to the next steps and wash off the other mask. I'm almost done peeling the face mask. I just wanted to give a little tip, because I know people like to take things to the extreme. With the Mr. Blanc teeth whitening, or any teeth whitening in general, these ones you leave on for 30 minutes once a day, and you can do it every day. But you're not gonna want to extend the period of time. It works the best, 30 minutes once a day, 14 days for best results. I remember I heard a story of a girl in a tanning bed, because you're only allowed to go once, not that you should tan in a tanning bed ever, but she really wanted a tan for a big event, and she went to multiple tanning salons because you're only legally allowed to go once a day. And she went to so many tanning salons, she boiled from the inside out and died. I think she was getting ready for prom. So please do not take things to the extreme. Just a little tip. All right, we are now in the bath and I'm filled with bubbles, but we're gonna wash off the face mask. So let's go. I'm gonna take out my hair, which is just gonna look amazing right now, right? The shampoo and conditioner that I really, really love is the Pureology NanoWorks. It is pretty pricey, but if you bleach your hair or color your hair, have damaged hair, this is a lifesaver. So I'm gonna shampoo my hair so I can get conditioner in and let it sit when we do everything else. So let me wet my hair, actually. All right, time to go under. The next step is to exfoliate because I plan on doing a fake tanner, and I'm also shaving. Exfoliating can help me not get
Frieza bun, which I tend to really get.
The scrub I'm using is the Soap and Glory Breakfast Scrub. I haven't really used this one too much. I'm kind of trying it out. So I'm going to exfoliate to prep for shaving and self-tanna. Gonna do arms and leg.
Oh yeah, I really need to shave my legs.
The next step I'm going to do is shave and with a shaving cream. This is the EOS one and this is a Venus razor. I don't really have a favorite shaving cream or razor. I hate disposable razors. They give me razor burn like crazy. This is just what I'm using right now.
Oh, yeah. Leg.
I just applied some Saint Tropez Gradual Tan. I have the medium dark one. I also really like their like actual mousse self-tanner, but I wanted more of a natural one. Next step, I'm going to do my nails. I've never done one of these, so I hope it works, but I'm really bad at painting my nails, so this is the next best thing. And God, this one's just so cute. I got this from Shop Jean, in case you are wondering, but I think they sell this brand at a lot of places. Okay, so you just find one that fits, and it says press down for no air bubbles. No air bubbles. And file away. Let's see if this actually works. Voila! Here they are finished. It actually didn't take that long once I got a hang of it. I'm kind of obsessed with these nail stickers. I just wish I had longer nails so I could do like longer designs. I feel like I cut so much off. Here's all the excess. And I'm kind of bummed you only get one of these. So now I have to buy more. But aren't they cute? My favorite is this one. Babe, which one's your favorite? Actually, no, the smiley.
French fries.
Really? French fries.
I'm going to prime the face with Make It Forever Primer in the green one. I only have a bunch. I don't think there's an actual number, but the green, and this will help cancel out any redness and have my makeup stay all day through the big event. For foundation, I'm going to use the MAC Mineralize Liquid Foundation, and I'm just going to apply that with my hands. Under the eyes, I'm going to take the Benefit Erase Paste and I'm gonna dab it on my fingers and then blend it out with a beauty blender, a slightly damped beauty blender. And just put that in a triangle formation underneath your eyes to help highlight too. A little bit in the inner corners. I'm going to use the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot to prime my eyes. I'm going to put this on top and underneath. And I'm just using my finger again. I'm going to move on to eyebrows, and I'm using the Brow Wiz Loose Powder from Anastasia in medium brown. And I'm just taking an angled brush that I dipped in Fix Plus, and I'm going to make kind of like, not like a gel, but a liquid to fill in my brows. And I'm just going to push my bangs aside. And I'm going to work on the bottom. I'm going to like create an outline and not take it on the inside too much. And like this. And you're going to want to make the up. And here you can see the difference. I mean, mine will be covered with bangs, but if you don't, this is just a...
Sorry.
What?
So weird.
What? Fine, let's not do this. Now we get to move on to eyes. I'm going to use a Lime Crime Venus palette. I showed you this look on Snapchat. If you don't follow me, it's Baylin Brittany. But I showed it to you guys and I asked you guys if you wanted to see a look on it, so I'm gonna do it right now. All right. I'm going to start with the color Aura, and I'm going to use this. It's pretty much like a really light champagne color, so I'm going to use this as a highlight. And I'm also going to throw it into the inner corner and take it a little bit on the inside and a little bit under. Now I'm taking the color Shell. It is
how do I describe it? It's a pink with orange iridescence, kind of like NARS Orgasm, but an eyeshadow version. And I'm gonna take this on the same MAC 217 brush, and I'm gonna just put this all over my lid and blend it into my crease. This is a very easy look because the messier, the better. And this is gonna be our base blending color, but this is a pretty light look. It's a light grunge look. I'm also gonna take this color underneath my eye. Same brush, keeping it simple. Now I'm going to take Divine, and it is a matte gray color, and I'm gonna use this to start darkening everything up right in the corner. I'm gonna take it in the crease and a little bit along the lash line and underneath the eye just a tad. Now I'm gonna go in with, what are you, Creation. It's kind of a warm, dusty rust color. That's a weird explanation. And I'm just gonna take this on a crease brush. This one is just the Kirkland one, I think. I'm gonna take it into the crease and start warming everything up. And this is gonna make it really smoky and grungy. And I'm also gonna take this underneath, because we want that underneath to be really smoked and really thick. Yeah. I'm going to take Creation again, and this time very carefully, I'm going to bring this. Ooh, what are you? You're just a piece of lint. We're gonna take this really close. Inward, like underneath our eyebrow, but leave a little bit of space for a highlight. Smoking this in here really creates nice shadow, and I don't know, I really like it. It looks messy right now, but just keep messing with it and blending it, and we can re-highlight this, and it will make it look, you know, messy but clean. I'm going to use the dark brown color Icon. Yeah, Icon, on the same crease brush, and I'm going to, whoa, I got a lot, gonna take some off. I'm gonna put that into the crease to help define the crease and not blend it out too much. Defining the crease, then we're gonna take it under here again. We want this to be the darkest area. All I did was darken up slightly what we had already done and then blended. And now I'm going to take the Chela highlighter, but I'm going to take it just in my waterline. If you have a nude eyeliner, that would work amazingly, but I don't, so I cheat with this, and it works pretty well. Nothing too crazy. And curl your lashes to prep for falsies. I like this look without eyeliner. If you are an eyeliner lover, then you can totally go ahead, but I prefer it without. So I'm just gonna prep still with mascara. I'm using the Smashbox Full Exposure, and I'm gonna do that just very lightly. Pretty much I just do this to make my eyelashes black so they blend. Not trying to make them all crazy. I am using Ardell number 111 eyelashes. And let's do this. Okay. Listen to me, eyelashes. This is where I want you to go. When I let my eyelashes dry, I'm going to come back to the face. It's been a while. So I'm going to just dab with a beauty blender anything that kind of fell, gonna brush away. And I'm also taking a small amount of concealer with that, just in case anything has fallen. We can do this because we have not powdered yet, which will be our next stop. Now using the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder, and I have no idea what brush this is, I'm sorry guys. Oh, it's a Makeup Forever 140 brush. I'm going to set my under eyes by just patting a bunch of powder, and then I will brush it away. And I'm also gonna set the highlights of my face. So my nose, above my lip, my chin, a little bit under my cheekbones, anywhere I want to brighten. Taking the Anastasia Contour Palette, I'm going to take pretty much just all of these, mostly the middle one, and I'm going to contour slightly lower. It will, I don't know, I feel like it gives it a more like Vogue vampy vibe. You just go a little bit under. Okay, I'm going to highlight now, and I'm going to use the Balm Mary Luminizer so I can open you. And ooh, yes. Such a good highlight. We are almost done. I'm just going to apply mascara now that my eyelashes are dry. And I'm gonna do it to the top a little bit and the bottom. Top to blend, and the bottom because they look pretty bare right now. Last step, the lips. I'm using ColourPop Ultra Matte Lip in Trap, which is such a dupe for Lime Crime in Cashmere. So, here we go. And we're done, yay! Well, we still have hair, but makeup in check. The hair, I want to keep it super simple, and I've really been loving like my hair up, especially like a little top knot with my bangs. So I'm gonna do something like that. It's gonna be really fast. I'm just gonna take out some pieces, see what I like the best. I like a little bit of framing around my face. What I'm going to do is just twist my hair in a little teeny dump knot. And I'm gonna take a hair tie, go around twice, and easiest hair in the world.